हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू अवर यूट्यूब चैनल बाय ज्ञानमंजरी मॉडर्न स्कूल। अवर सब्जेक्ट इज साइंस फॉर स्टैंडर्ड 9th एंड अवर करंट चैप्टर इज चैप्टर नंबर 10, ग्रेविटेशन। इन दिस चैप्टर वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द फोर्स ऑफ ग्रेविटेशनल यूनिवर्सल लॉ ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन अगेन एंड अगेन इन ईच पीरियड। इन द स्टार्टिंग आई एम रिवाइजिंग दिस लॉ बिकॉज इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट लॉ, यूनिवर्सल लॉ ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन। It is the there is a force of attraction between any two objects in the universe, and this force of attraction is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them, and the force of attraction is along the line joining their centers. This line should be written in the universal law of gravitation. And also we have studied about the value of capital G and value of small g. What is capital G? Capital G is a constant of proportionality and small g is acceleration due to gravity. The value of capital G is always constant everywhere and it is equal to 6.67 into 10 raised to minus 11 Newton meter square per kg square. And value of G, as it is acceleration, its value is 9.8 meter per second square. But value of G is not small g is not constant everywhere. There is a slight difference because it is the force of attraction. If object is on the pole, the force of attraction is more. If object is at the equator, it is somewhat away from the center, therefore force of attraction is less, and therefore due to that the value of G decreases. As the distance increases, value of G decreases. If the distance decreases, value of small g increases. I am discussing about small g. Capital G is constant, 6.67 into 10 raised to minus 11. Okay. Also students, in the last period we have discussed about the mass and weight. What is the difference between mass and weight? Mass means quantity of matter in the body and weight is the acceleration, gravitational force acting on an object is called weight. Now mass remains constant and weight is not constant everywhere because the force of attraction is can be increased or can be decreased. It is related to the space where the object is. Again, mass is a scalar quantity. It does not require the direction for complete description. Weight is a vector quantity because it requires direction along with magnitude. Again, what is the unit? Unit of mass is kg. Unit of weight is Newton because it is the force, and we know the unit of force is Newton. If it is written as the name of the scientist, then NEWT, it should be written in the small letter, and if we just write one letter, then it should be capital. These are the rules to write the units. So in this way, the next difference, mass can be measured with the use of beam balance and weight is measured using spring balance. So these are the difference between mass and weight. The mass remains constant everywhere, but weight changes according to the where the subject is located. Where is the subject? According to the place of the object, the value of weight can be increased, can be decreased, means changes. Now students, this everything about this we have discussed in the previous session. Now if we compare the mass, if we compare the weight or force of attraction of the earth and moon. Now it is calculated that the force of attraction of the moon is 1/6 times than that of the earth. So because the moon, mass of moon is very less and force of attraction is also very less than compared to the earth, and mass of the earth is 6 times more, force of attraction is 6 times more than that of the moon. Now students, here we will see about mass. Suppose one object is having mass, suppose it is having mass 50 kg on earth, so it will definitely have mass 50 kg on moon. So there is no any change in masses as it is on the earth or it is on the moon. But let's see about weight. Suppose on moon, weight of any object on the earth is suppose 60 newton. So its mass, its weight on the moon is 10 Newton. 1 upon 6 times, so weight on the earth is 60. So we can divide 60 by 6. So we get answer, weight on the moon is 10 Newton. And vice versa, if on moon, if its weight is suppose 1.4 Newton, so on earth its weight will be 6 times that, 8.4 Newton. So in this way, this type of questions can be asked in the objective questions, in the question A, section A. What is the earth? But always the mass remains constant. This type of tricky questions can be there. If the mass of the object on the earth is 50 kg, so what will be the mass of the object on the moon? So it is 50 kg same. Now we will see how to convert from mass to the weight. That we will learn today. We will see some examples, because in the difference we have learned one point. Mass is the eccentric quantity. There is no any formula to find out the mass, because it is a fundamental property of an object. Without mass, object can't exist. Just we can measure the mass, we can't calculate the mass by any formula. And weight can be calculated as it depends on the gravitational force of the earth, and it is denoted by W is equal to m into g, mass into gravitational force. Students, again I am repeating, very important statement is this: mass is constant everywhere. There is no any formula to calculate the mass, because it is the fundamental eccentric property of an object. But for weight, W is equal to mg, mass into gravitational force. Now students, let's have one example which is already given in your textbook. Take out example number 10.4. Page number 138. Example 10.4. See what it is. Mass of an object is 10 kg. So just make the list. Mass is equal to 10 kg. Don't forget to write unit, students. It's very important. What is its weight? So we have to calculate weight. So make the question mark. Now we know the formula. W is equal to m into g. Students, W is equal to 10, and we know value of g is equal to 9.8. Students, if it is given the value of g, acceleration due to gravity, then you have to substitute that value. Suppose sometime it is given that it is 10 newton or 9.6 newtons, whatever it may be. But if it is not given, you have to consider the value of g as 9.8. So if it is not given, substitute the value of small g as 9.8 meter per second square. Otherwise, if it is given, substitute that value. Very simple and clear. When we multiply 9.8 into 10, we are getting 98 newton. So in this way, we can find out the value of W, means weight. If mass is given, just note down this, students, I am giving you 1 minute. Okay, the next sum, students, we will example, which is given in your textbook. It is 10.5. An object weight 10 newton when measured on the surface of the earth. So here given weight 10 newton. On earth it is given. And we have to calculate the value of weight of that object on the moon. So W we have to calculate on moon. This is simple, this much information is given. We know the weight of an object on the earth is 6 times more than the weight of an object on the moon. Here on the earth is given. So here we know Wm is equal to We upon 6. What is the meaning? That Wm, suppose we say it is E. E means earth, M means moon. On earth, weight is given 10. And on moon, we have to find the its weight. So weight means gravitational force. But these are very, very simple things, and again I am repeating. So give attention here. Wm. What is We? It is 10. What is division? 10.6 is equal to 1.67 newton. How it comes? 10 divided by 6. 6 ones are 6. 4.036. 4.6, 36 again. We are getting 4 again 6. So actually it is 1.67. I am showing you how why we have taken 67. Actually it is recurring number 1.666666. Now students, always in mathematics or it may be in science, if we have to do the division maximum up to 3 or 4 stages. Here we have done for 3 decimal places. Now we see the third decimal place. If the third decimal place is 5 or more than 5, then one will be added in a previous digit. Okay, see, this is always valid for maths and science. Suppose it is 1.666. So we can write it like this, 1.67, because here the third place is more than 5. Suppose the it is like this, any number. So what will be its value? Its value will be 1.54 only, because third place is less than 5. So no any one will be added, any number will be added in a previous one. If this is 5 or more than 5, then and then only one will be added in a previous figure. Again, I will take one more example. Suppose 26.735. It may be recurring, it may not be recurring, whatever it may be. But approximately, if we want to write up to 2 digit only, then it will be 26.74, because here third digit is more than 5. For more than 5, then 1 will be added in the previous figure. Here in this case, here 4 is there, 4 is less than 5, so nothing will be added in previous figure. So these are the rules of mathematics, students, and you have to keep in mind these rules. It will be very useful to you in the future, and also this year also it will be useful in the standard 10th, in the statistics, mean, mode, median. So there are we are getting 4 digits after the decimal point. So if we want to take only 2 or 3 digits, then the 1 will be added if this figure is 5 or more than 5. Suppose, students, we want to take 3 digits. Suppose 7.8, 3, 3 and 5. So if the situation is like this, so in this case you can write 7.8, 3 and 4. So if this digit is 5 or more than 5, it can be 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it may be, so 1 will be added in the previous figure. So it is very necessary to having the knowledge of this type, students. Just note down this also, it will be useful to you. Okay, now let's solve some more numericals based on this. Students, I would like to inform you, cancelled portion from this chapter. Take out page number 138 from your textbook. Thirst and pressure, this point, from here it is cancelled. Again, this page is also cancelled. These both pages are also cancelled, students. Archimedes' principle, and also this portion is cancelled. Students, soon we will post the cancelled portion in our group from maths and science, so don't worry. But students, one interesting thing about the Archimedes principle. It is not included in your syllabus, but just I want to tell you. Have you ever experienced, suppose you can do it at your home, just the activity is there, very interesting it is. If your bucket is full of water, just take the tumbler and tie a rope, take a bucket full of water. And take a tumbler tie it with rope. Now when insert the tumbler in this water, okay, first of all what you do, insert the tumbler in water and slowly pull it out. So when you pull it out, you will feel that it is not having any weight on it. Slowly pull it. But as this tumbler comes out from water, you feel it heavy. You can do it your own. So it is a very interesting property of, and it is invented by the great scientist Archimedes. Why this is so? When the tumbler is in bucket and when you try to pull it, you will feel it is very light. But as it comes out from the surface of the bucket, then you feel that tumbler is heavy. Student, why this is so? This is our tumbler. Okay. Why this is so? Because when the tumbler is inside the bucket, inside the water, water gives its buoyant force from the lower side. So it feels very light. But as the tumbler comes out from the water, there will be no any buoyant force. And therefore the tumbler, we feel the tumbler is heavy. This same for the well. When the women take out the bucket from well, then when the bucket is in the water, up till that it feel light. But as it comes out from water, then it feel heavy because there is no water, no buoyant force. And this was discovered by the scientist Archimedes, and therefore it is called Archimedes principle. So this year this topic is not included at all, but if you have interest in science, just read this. So it, you will be happy by reading this, and you will get very new fresh information which you haven't learned in the lower standard. So just for this, I am, for your interest, I told this about this topic in you today. Students, now the time for homework. Just numericals, examples 10.4, 10.5. And students, again write the difference between G, capital G, and small g. This is the homework for today. Okay, bye. Take care. We will meet in the new session with a new chapter.